Hello Flip Noise users. Today's video we're going to be using Logic Pro 9 and we're going to be demonstrating some MIDI sequencing skills. And we're going to use a video to give you some idea, something to base it around. And I've just got a few loops that I've got in and a little bass line that I wrote, some stabs that I wrote. So just to have some music and to do some editing to that along the way. So obviously you'd write it to the video a little bit more, but right, so at the moment we've got a video in, which if you can't see the video, you click on global tracks and you can control or right click the word global tracks. It brings up this menu here and you can literally just tick on and off the subheadings that you want. I want video on, so I'll click that on, and then the video track comes up there. I can click on there, I can remove the video, or I can detect cuts, or this will be open movie if it wasn't there. You could also drag and drop it in. It tends to split the audio up that way. Okay, so this is what we've got. Your video window can be placed anywhere. If you close it down, it will appear over in the left hand side. So that might be big enough there for you to watch. If not, double click it and reshape it to anywhere you want. Put it somewhere where it's out of the way. And yeah, the first thing we're gonna look at is, once you've got the video in, is the timing of it is quite important. For example, if you're working on an advert or something like this, this is like a no waste like home television program. About saving energy. If you was writing the music for this, then you would want the timing to be exactly right. There's no use putting 20 seconds on the end if you're doing a sync job. So you'd want to time it exactly from the beginning. You might want to put everything on bar one, but the ending's important at the end of the video. So wherever this is, can you see that white end marker there? It cuts off the end of your track there, so that's quite useful. You can line that up with the end of the video. Next thing, say you want to record any external MIDI on here, you can add a track and you can go to external MIDI, obviously audio, to record some voices, guitars, whatever, from outside using an interface. Software instrument, so anything here, software based, or actually you could use external plugins, that's external internal if you know what I mean, and then external MIDI means a bit of hardware outside, like a, I don't know, JD800, DX7, whatever you want to record in. So when you click on external MIDI, it'll ask you two questions. Here are the two questions. What MIDI interface do you want to use? So you could select that, and in my case I'd probably just use general MIDI device I've got set up. And which MIDI note do you want to use? Sorry, not MIDI note, MIDI channel. What MIDI channel do you want to use? So you'd set this to whatever channel your external instrument was on. And you would hit record, and this will send MIDI messages out to your external hardware. That's pretty useful. I'm just going to delete that for now. And what else have we got? We've got a couple of ways to put notes in. So for example, we could put the metronome on, and let's just put a drum machine on. So I'm going to insert a drum machine software instrument from Logic, and I'm just going to load something called Ultrabeat. Okay, and I should be able to just press cap locks and a little keyboard comes up that I can use. Okay, so I'm just playing the typing keyboard, but I can use that. It's handy on the train if you're going somewhere and want to write some music. And I'm just going to write a little loop in then. So I'm going to put the metronome on so I can keep in time as it's real time recording, and then listen to the counting, and I'm going to let it, I'm not going to hit it straight away, I'm going to let it go and cycle first. So it's a 2-bar intro, and then I'll start recording on the next loop. Let it go round anywhere I want. Okay, so let's just solo that. And I'm just going to click off the metronome. I'll finish with that now. Okay, so I wanted actually to get a 16th pattern in there. I've purposely missed a few out because I want to show you a few editing functions on available on Logic. So you can double click it, and when you double click it, let's get rid of the video so we can see what we're doing here. There we go. If you double click it, you get the piano roll editor at the bottom, and this is what I've recorded in. Okay, and the first thing I want to do is quantize that. So I can select all the notes. A good way of doing it is Command A, selects all the notes, and I can go to here and choose what kind of swing I want or groove I want on there. I'm just going to put 16th notes in for now. And then once I'm happy with that, I quantize it, click there. If I want another groove, just watch the notes change. There you go, that's just got a swing. Yeah, and any notes, I'm just going to put it back to 16th for now. Any notes that I want to change, let's make it a bit smaller so I can see. It might be nice to put one at the beginning. So just to have a look at the beginning, something like that might want to go there. So you can hold Alt down and just copy all the notes or one of the notes. I just want to copy one of the notes, so we'll crack that, drop it at the beginning of the loop there. And these things at the bottom, you probably don't see those, you probably see it like that. If you click on here, I always leave my velocity on there. Whichever one you selected, you can turn the velocity down. Sometimes it's nice, every other on a 16th, just to lower it, just to give it like a human feel. If I exaggerate it, you can hear what it does at the beginning of the bar, especially if I solo that. You'll hear the velocity, hard, soft, hard, soft. Yeah, okay, and the other way to put in data, obviously you record a bass line in or piano or chords, anything like that in real time, you have to do it to the metronome. It's like performing on stage, you're performing with other stuff. The other way to input MIDI is using, well, a couple of ways. You could use a step input keyboard, just there. I actually prefer to use something like Ultra B again, but this time, let me just delete that pattern. This time what I'm going to do is double click Ultra B itself, the actual drum B that we was in, and you can change a load of kits there if you wanted to. Loads and different ones there. Let's try a different one. Let's try Electro House kit. Okay, a bit tied to Maraca there. But this time what I'm going to do, I'm going to switch this sequencer on at the bottom. And if we switch the sequencer on, what that'll allow us to do is put stuff in step. I'm just having a look how long my video is, because I don't like to go on too long videos. So I'm going to switch the sequencer on and go to this button at the bottom called Full View, and it turns it into a step sequencer. Very popular in the 80s, 90s, early 90s anyway, before the Atari ST computer came along. What this does, if I play it, it puts the drum bands in. So these are just, I could take these off, and each one is a sound. So you can just see it's just left with the kick drum. If I just leave one, say, on the downbeat, this is called the very first beat. And this grid just represents two bars. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So it's just two bars long. And what I like about it is you can stripe it and put various kits in. Obviously the snare as well. And you get used to where these go. Oh, not very nice snare, but there you go. Synth knock, that is. Let's try this one. Uh, But what I do like about it is things like maracas, you can right click on that or control click, however you got your Mac set up, randomize the velocity. Now the velocity is how hard that it's hit, and it instantly gives like a more human groove to it, because that actually sounds pretty naff, to be honest. It sounds like a computer's written, which it has. So okay, so just with that random velocity, random gate is how long the note's played for. Don't really hear that on a short hi-hat anyway. And if you wanted to get rid of any the odd note along the way, just to give it more of a feel, more of a groove, more of a shuffle. And you've got all these sounds as well that you can just... Wow. Yeah, so that's step input. And this is 10 minutes long now, so I'm going to split these videos into a couple of videos, I think. And with step recording, you can... two ways of putting it in: step recording or step in, step sequencing, and real-time recording using the metronome. Incidentally, some of you may be wondering, once we've put a pattern in this, how do we get it in our song? And it's tucked away in this little grey box just here. If you pick it up and drop it down anywhere in your Ultrabeat track, remember to switch your sequencer off, otherwise this is going to play and that's going to play. And then we're going to just loop that. A good way of doing that is highlight it, set locators. And then this should play this drum beat now. But this time it's played in here. So here is our pattern. And you can edit it just the same with velocities and stuff like that, however you want to. Using the piano roll down here. So I hope that helps, and in the next video we will look at a few other things with to do with editing. In fact, we're going to be looking at tempo and a bit of automation, going a bit deeper, looking at filter controls and things like that. Hope you enjoy this video, and there'll probably be about three parts to this video.